Well, hello there. I pray that God has kept you. I just wanted to take a few minutes just to say thank you for all those who have checked in on me. And even those that didn't check in on me, I want to let you know that I've been praying on this side for you. I wanted to send this message out for those who are still yet being tested and tried during this trying time. And want to let you know that I still have hope for us. You know, the Bible tells us in 1 Corinthians 13:13, and now these three remain, faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of these is love, and I thank God that we are all demonstrating that love today. I appreciate you. I pray that God has really quickened you to realize that he is guiding us with his eyes. For those who don't know, the Lord has shown me this dream concerning this matter. And I was just talking to one of the prophetess that's been a part of our ministry for a while, and we were talking about the eclipse. If you notice that things start to happen pretty quickly right after the eclipse, there was something happened that day. Much happened to me during that week. But God, I have not lost light of hope and know that the love for people, you know, that I know that God is showing me that love me and I love them. So in case I haven't talked to you in a while, in case you haven't heard from me, know that I do love you and I do appreciate you. Am I being challenged in this storm? You bet I am. But it doesn't have anything to do with the natural. It is in my body. But God, he is so good and he is still yet showing me love. That love, do you know that it strengthens people when you call them or you show them love just from a phone call? You know, it is just so much love. But I want to share this message that he's talked to me about during that eclipse time. I was walking in Walmart on that same day of the eclipse. And my body started to propel, I was telling the prophetess. My body started to propel. Usually when that happens, it's letting me know that something's about to happen where he is letting me know that I am fixed to engage in a very, very intense warfare. And so my body began to propel up as I began to get out of the car. I felt my body walk as though I was walking on a cloud. When I got in the store, same thing. I was like, wow, Daddy. So I began to intercede and pray. And before I left the store, I went, God, it is something that's about to happen. Mercy, Lord. And I knew that it had to do also with the eclipse for this storm and this time that we're in. There is an eclipse in the spirit, and God is really, really talking to us. But the word that I gave you all concerning the dream, he showed me that those who truly love me, those who have repented, those who are staying close to me, you do not have to worry. The water may come, but it shall not come nigh. And if it comes, it's not going to overtake you. That's very, very key. It will not overtake us. And he gave me Psalms 32 and verse 6 that says, for this shall everyone that is godly pray. For this shall everyone that is godly pray unto thee in a time when thou mayest be found. Surely in the floods of great waters they shall not come nigh unto him. And we got to believe that. And that's what he spoke to me when I saw this 7 years ago. Remember? It's 7 years this year that he showed me this. And I am telling you now that we need to pay attention when the prophets are speaking. The other thing that I wanted to say about this time that God is using each of us to show love and bringing our hearts to a repentant state, we got to really, really begin to repent for the things that we know that so easily beset us and the things that we've allowed our hearts to get in that position, because we know not what the day holds. My heart has just been so heavy watching those who've lost loved ones, you know, even those officials that have come to help, where there's been looting and robbing and everything else. As I sit and watch the news in the comfort of my home, where I've got air, where there's no water, there's nothing that has come nigh me. My neighbor's carport fell right next to me, and nothing touched Sandy stuff. No water came near Sandy, just like our daddy promised. But I'm telling you, those who are being challenged, whether it's in your family or whether it's in your own life, you need to know that we got to open our eyes in the spirit. Tomorrow will be our 8th day of our challenge to ask God to open our eyes in the spirit, where we may have an open vision to see what is he showing us right now for the time that we're in. Press in and pray. Get along with God. He began to show me to open my eyes to see how grateful that I have been to many. I find that you may know that you know the lifestyle. You know where they are, but yet my grace abided. I find it. And in the love of our God, which I love for him, should never ever see that he is a God that is not of love, because he is a God of love, he's a God of mercy, and he's surely a God of wrath. And we got to know that we need to look at the time. Because I began to be alone, and every time I flipped my light on, and every time I had my air conditioning going, every time I got to the toilet, I sat down. Every time I got to take a bath, every time I got ready to put a piece of food in my mouth. I don't want to preach. Hey, my God. All I could do before I eat, my stomach began to have a bittersweet, not to get to pray. I couldn't hardly eat it. I said, God, have mercy today. Some baby is hungry. Some mother is hungry. Somebody just got out of the water is hungry. And somebody is cold. Somebody is hot. My God, and I got air. Hey, I know I'm talking to somebody. Hey, and I can take a bath, and I don't have to worry about somebody snoring or smelling bad by me. I'm laying in the comfort of my own bed. And every time I got ready to eat that food, I began to say, my God, have mercy today. Make it available, Daddy. Make it available because your love never fails us. Hey, I just got bittersweetness in my stomach when I began to eat, thinking about the babies that would be hungry and the children that's waiting to be fed. Hey, my God. And so we must be grateful. And so I opened my eyes to really be able to see those things that made me grateful because I had a bittersweetness. Thinking that, Lord, you know, what manner of a God was he so loving and so merciful toward me when there's no good in none of us? And so we still have time, you need to know that, to volunteer. We still have time to go somewhere even after this storm is over. So don't get comfortable thinking, well, they got plenty of help, FEMA's there. You better pay attention to what I'm saying to you. You better open your eyes. A whole bunch of FEMA stuff, and I'm not coming against FEMA, but a whole bunch of situations at hand. It's going to be a much more sore than we think. You got to watch and understand everything free ain't good. We got to pay attention to the principalities that try to use. And so we got to pay attention. God is sovereign, but he wants to recognize the love that we lack today, the forgiveness that he's calling us to repent about, you know, so that he can give the forgiveness. So we still have time. We still have time. The rain has lifted in some places, but as you watch the news, you can see there's still so much hurting everywhere. Before I got on here, I saw the nursing home water just in the nursing home. Lord have mercy. And so we still have time to pray and intercede for these communities and these families. And we got to remember that God is still able. So we need to choose to be in love. We need to choose to want to give. We need to choose to make sure that we help one another. We need to choose to repent our Sunday because you know the condition of your heart. Come on now. And I want to leave this word so I get off here. My word for the day I want to leave with you, I thought it was very, very powerful from my devotion. It says, it is often true that the path towards the light is through a tunnel of darkness. It is also true that during the bleakest periods of our lives, we discover within ourselves powerful resources we never knew we possessed. And that you know what that is? That's faith. We squeezed that mustard seed. We had nothing. When we saw this rain, these resources of strength, of character, yeah, he's checking that. It's character, it's courage, it's faith, it's love, it's endurance, it's tolerance, yes it is, and it's patience, yes God. It is during the darkest moments of our lives when we think that there is no hope for us, that the light comes, yes it does. It comes from these hidden resources that shines brightest, yes. Those hidden resources that God was sent by the hater, sent by the person that never gave you a hello. Yeah. And he let them bless you. I can't even begin to describe to you how much love I've been given over this time, this period, from so many. And I want to say thank you. It goes on to say, this knowledge awakens our awareness that the pathways to wisdom do exist. For we have discovered that we can walk through the most agonizing moments of our existence if we use these newfound spiritual tools. Mm-hmm. Each day of our lives, whether we are in pain or not, or in trouble or not, can be borne because we have this spiritual armor to protect us. Yes, it's going to protect us. This is the light that we see at the end of the tunnel of darkness. Guess what its name is? And its name is hope. Yes, its name is love. Yeah, hope and love. But out of all of these, faith, hope, love is going to be the greatest. I'm talking to you right now. I know I am. Whether you're angry at a loved one, whether you're angry at your spouse, whether you're angry at your children, I'm telling you right now, it's way too late. It's time to repent. Wrap your arms around them. Make sure you go back and repent to that leader. Make sure you do what you got to do because you know not what tomorrow holds. Guess what? Hate to make the announcement, but it ain't over yet. God is still yet cleansing. And here's what my word is today to you. I choose, say this after me, I choose, you got to want it though, I choose to walk in the light, yes, with the spiritual resources God has given me. Say it again. I choose to walk in the light with the spiritual resources God has given me. And you know what those is. Faith, hope, and most importantly, it is love. If you haven't forgiven, forgiveness is love. God bless you. I pray that you will tell somebody that you know that you're going through a challenge right now, that you love them, that you and that you want to repent to them. And most importantly, remember, you have got to serve. It does you no good to fast and pray, and you don't help a sister and a brother out. You may not be able to get out right now to do it, but guess what? A day's ahead, there's going to be many opportunities to demonstrate your true agape love that's through nobody but our Daddy God. Now you can let His light shine. That's going to be one of your resources, is demonstration of His love. God bless you.